not being arrogant in any way. I think for me to have dropped out of the league, which I'd worked so hard to get into, that this would have been the only job that I would have took to come back into the conference, and certainly glad that I took that opportunity. Watching from afar, I think it's a club that, you know, everyone seems to have a favourite second club, and it seems to be Leyton Orient. But obviously, I see that, you know, Steve had been parted ways with the club, so I you know, obviously knew that the opportunity had become available for the manager's job. I spoke, I'm a representative, spoke with Martin. Might have thought it would be a good idea to come and watch the game. I come to watch one of the games that Ross took against Dover. You know, what I saw on the day was certainly there was spirit within the team. I think what you always got to understand and take into account is the group of players were a long period without a win, and you know, if anyone that's played the game knows that will affect them. Confidence will be affected. Don't matter how mentally strong you think you are as an individual or you think you are collectively, not winning for a long period of time affects you. It's fact. I think you're right in terms of the performance I got at Solihull was very disappointing and quite worrying, if I'm honest. I think I spoke about it after. I didn't have the impact that I thought I would in the performance. And I think it made me fully aware of how fragile the group of players were, collectively and individually. So I think what the following week allowed me was to have a 4 weeks training with the group to certainly clear up any grey areas and let everyone know what I was about and what I expected from the group of players individually, collectively, and from then on, I think, you know, the praise and the rewards have to go to the players because they've been incredible. From a period of, I'm not sure the correct number, I think 15 games without a win, to go on the run that they have since. And I think in my 48 games, we've only lost 9. I think that speaks volumes to what this group is all about. And, you know, I can't tell you how proud of the group I am to have been able to deliver the consistent performances, results that they have over this period of time, coming off the back of what was a terrible couple of months. And I think people forget it's not just about them couple of months. You know, over the last 2, 3, 4 years, this club was used to losing, and not only losing but being relegated. So to turn that around as quickly as we have, I think is a huge testament, and congratulations to the group of players. I think me building relationships with individuals, I needed to win their trust, and they needed to know that I trusted them. So I went about that very quickly. I think making it quite clear the way we were going to play, and take no risks, because I've always known if you're a player that's low on confidence, you need to have very few opportunities to make mistakes and to not have too many complications in your game. So I think I stripped it down. I went back to basics. I think I picked a system that suited the players rather than a system that was asked to fit the players in. I think I simplified that. I think over that week we spoke about attitude to training, what was expected in training, the way we were going to go about our work every day. And I asked the players to commit, not just for a week, not for 2 weeks, but for every day that they come to training, they play, they're associated with Lake Norrie, that they commit, and they have committed to that. And I think I just tried to make it as simple as possible and take away the decision making, which can be clouded when you're very up against it as a player. What I learned very quickly was there was a group of players here that I didn't feel needed too much change to. Like I say, I think what we did is we gained momentum, we gained trust, we had a very good understanding of roles and responsibilities on the pitch, and that's continued. Like I say, without sounding like a broken record, that is credit and testament to this group of players that every day, and I don't mean some days, every day that they come in, they are at full tilt. They know what's expected. They know what's expected of one another now. They've set the standards, they've delivered the results, they've delivered the performances, and they demand and drive that of each other every day.